Good afternoon, my friends. This is Michael. I just wanted to take this opportunity just to say hi. I hope you're all doing well. And also to thank you all for your kind comments regarding some of the videos that I've shared over the last few days. It's given me an opportunity during this lockdown to think back on my life in magic. And I got really present to just how fortunate I've been to have met certain people. And one thing led to another, doors got opened, and I was able to meet some extraordinary individuals in the world of magic. In my recent videos, I paid tribute to Larry Jennings and Derek Dingle. And as I think about them now, I can honestly say they were two of the greatest sleight of hand artists I've ever seen in my life. Derek Dingle in particular, because what I found interesting with Derek was the fact that he was operating inside a very social environment, a pub, a bar, and he was comfortable in that realm, entertaining people who had just come in from work, and all they wanted to do was watch the ball game and have a beer. And if he felt like it, he would do a few card tricks for them. That was the experience I had of him. He was easygoing, he was cheeky, he was friendly and sociable. And this really gave me an inkling into his style and how he liked to present magic to people. Not with the flashy bells and whistle of a Las Vegas review, but just an ordinary guy hanging out with people, and interesting things happen out of the natural flow of conversation. This was of great interest to me because my mentor and I, Alan Allen, we spoke about this, and he always said to me, Michael, your script and delivery must appear conversational. It must appear as if the words are passing your lips for the first time. If it sounds scripted, then it comes across as very contrived. And this is something I've been working on for a very long time, because in the beginning, I was not a natural speaker. It's something that I've practiced and developed over the years. And it's had a big impact on how I present myself to an audience. So here's a little tip for you. When you practice your magic, naturally in front of a mirror or a video camera, play the video back. Film yourself, play the video back, and try and watch yourself with a critical eye. Listen to the sound of the words as they come out of your mouth. You will hear if it sounds authentic. You will hear if it sounds scripted. And if it does, well, put the beats in. Pause. Sometimes the most powerful message comes across when you're not actually saying anything. Alan always said to me, the hardest thing to do on stage is absolutely nothing. Silence is golden. I didn't fully appreciate what he said until I lost my hearing. And you know what? Being a deaf magician is actually pretty cool. And I say this without any ego or trying to be funny. The fact that I've lost my hearing, although my ears don't work, they don't work as well as they used to. Being deaf has meant I had to retrain myself to listen. Listening is a function of the mind. We hear the words being spoken, but doesn't mean you're listening. It means to engage and to be active in the conversation, even when you're not talking. How can you apply what I just said to your audience? As Darwin Ortiz said to me, Michael, listen to your audience. I'm going to leave it at that. Today's magic trick is a beautiful piece that Derek Dingle first shared with me. It's called Too Many Cards. I've added a little touch at the end, which I hope you like. Thanks for watching. Okay, good morning, my friends. This particular trick is one that I saw Derek Dingle perform behind the bar, and it left a big impression on me. And what I loved about it is its simplicity. Just five cards. I've got the Ace of Spades, the 2, the 3, the 4, and the 5. No more, no less. And then you probably notice all the cards are in sequence. We've got the Ace, the 2, the 3, the 4, and the 5. Step by step, very slowly. We'll start off with the Ace of Spades. The Ace goes in the middle, but never on the bottom. Just cast the spell, and that Ace rises back to the top. You know, I think I'm using too many cards, so let's try this with the 2. Just like the Ace, the 2 goes in the middle, but never on the bottom. And there it is, back on top. You know what? Let's do that again. Do you know something? I think I'm using too many cards here. All right. That's okay. Watch the 3. Now, the 3 goes in between the 4 and the 5. Now, did you notice? Was it face up or face down? What, face up? Oh, okay, let's start again. I'll tell you what. Watch the 3 going in between the 4 and the 5. Face up or face... I tell you what, I think I'm using too many cards here. Now, with only 2 cards left, got the 4 and the 5. Now, watch the 4. Watch the 4. As it goes beneath the 5, it just doesn't seem possible, does it? So watch, this is the front of the 4. This is the back. The 5 goes on top. And still, that's one card too many. So there's not much I can do with just one single card, right? So watch this. And that, my friends, is the Ambitious Classic. It's a routine that was created by Larry Jennings. It first appeared in Epilogue. And Dingle created a nice presentation called Too Many Cards. I think he may have been inspired by Slidini, because Slidini used that line when he did his coins through table. Either way, it works beautifully, and it's a lovely trick. Thanks for watching.